Welcome to Now in Android, your ongoing guide to what's new and notable in the world of Android development. In this episode, we'll cover the update of JPEG Compose and other JPEG libraries, Gemini on Samsung Galaxy, Play Recovery Tools, and more. Let's get started. We just released Compose January 24 Bill of Materials update, which includes version 1.6 of Compose libraries. This release largely focuses on performance improvement. We are seeing up to 20% improvement in scroll performance and up to 12% improvement to startup time in our benchmark. Furthermore, this release adds support for an experimental mode we are calling Strong Skipping Mode. Strong Skipping Mode relaxes some of the rules about which changes can skip recomposition. Along with performance improvement, the January release also introduced new features like nonlinear font scaling, drag and drop, support for LookOS scope in lazy list, and more. For further information, check out Ben's article. At Galaxy Unpacked in San Jose, Hiroshi shared how Google AI is creating new possibilities on Android with our long-standing partner, Samsung. The new Samsung Galaxy S24 series will use Gemini, Google's best-in-class foundational models, to power the next generation of AI capabilities. We implemented a new tool that prompts users to update to the latest version of an app. Play Recovery Tools allow developers to prompt users running specific versions of their app to update whenever they restart the app. Check out this story of two indie game developers. They teamed up to create their own game studio and entered Quick Play Game Jam in partnership with Google Play. Throughout the competition, the duo was able to bring their game jam concept to life and launch it on Google Play. We have several new releases launched in JPEG libraries. Along with January stable release of Compose, we released the first alpha version of Compose 1.7. This includes even further performance improvement from migrating Ripple to a new API. If you have customized Ripple in your app, check out the new migration document. Also, this release includes the experimental basic text field 2, the next generation of Compose text field API. It has powerful new APIs many developers have requested, like output transformation API. In fragment version 1.7.0, alpha 9, we create a new fragment-compose artifact. This is especially helpful for apps that are in the process of moving from a fragment-based architecture to a fully compose-based architecture. For example, in this new artifact, you can simply assign the content-composable method to an onCreateView method without calling composeView or viewCompositionStorage. Collection 1.4 adds new high-efficiency collections for storing primitive without boxing. If you are a heavy user of list, set, and map, I believe most of you are, check this out. We also updated test core version 1.6.0, alpha 5, along with 9 other test libraries. Since this release, we bumped the minimum API requirement to 19, or Android KitKat 4.4, which we announced Google Play service would no longer support since August 2023. You can see all the Android X release notes in the description below. That's it for this week with JPEG Compose update, other JPEG library releases, Gemini on Samsung Galaxy, Play Recovery Tools, and more. Check back soon for your next update from the Android developer universe, and happy Lunar New Year!